Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. On this episode, let's look at how to create a keyboard shortcut to get rid of notifications like these. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. You can go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So the annoying thing about getting notifications is if you're in the middle of something and your hands are on the keyboard, there's no way to dismiss them without lifting your hands up, going to the mouse or trackpad, going over and clicking on them. But you could set up a script to do this. And if you could set up a script to do this, then you could set a keyboard shortcut for it. So let's look at building a script in JavaScript, otherwise known as JXA, using Automator. So first, we need a way to test this. It's not easy to bring up notifications. You can set up reminders to remind you to do something in 1 minute. But it turns out that it's very easy to do it in Automator. There's a display notification action. Just search for that in the actions in Automator and add a bunch of them. So I have three here. If I run this, it presents me with three notifications. Now notice it has the close and show buttons. The way I got those is I went to System Preferences and I made sure under notifications for Automator that I had alerts selected. By default, it's banners. So select alerts and now you get a great way to quickly throw up a bunch of notifications so we can test our script. Now let's get to building something that will close them. So I'm going to create a new Automator document. I'm going to make it a quick action, which is also known as a service. So this way we can assign it to a keyboard shortcut. I'll show you how to do that at the end. So we'll create a quick action. And it's going to receive no input. It's not going to do anything special. It's going to work in any application. So let's get rid of all these for now. We'll bring them back to test. Now, we can first search for JavaScript. And everything we do here is going to be in JavaScript because unfortunately there's no action in here that's going to allow us to get this done. So we're going to have to do it either in AppleScript or JavaScript. And JavaScript, also known as JXA, JavaScript for automation, is the more modern way of doing it. So I'm going to paste in three lines of code. That's all it's going to take to do this. And the first two lines are pretty standard for almost any JavaScript. So you've got an app, you're assigning an app, in this case system events, because that's where those notifications are. Then you're doing the include standard editions, which means I can now do actions on this system events app. And the line that actually does it is this one. So let's dissect it. So we're taking the current app, system events. We're looking at the processes. There's a list of processes. And actually, it's about 100 processes long, depending upon what you've got going. But we're looking by name for one called Notification Center. So it's going to find out of the 100 or so processes that particular one. Then it's going to look at the array of windows and it's going to say, do something to all of them. So not pick out a particular window, but do it to all of them. For all of them, go to the first button and perform the action click. And that should do it. So let's save this. And let's try it out. I'm going to use Command and tilde to switch windows here and open up our test notifications. There they are. Now Command and tilde to go back to close all notifications. Can't quite see the run button, so I'm going to move the window down. I'll hit run and there it goes. It closed all those notification windows. Great. I've already saved it as a quick action so it's ready to go. And since I put no input and in any application, I should see it appear in the services menu. So I'll go to Automator Services and I should see close all notifications. There it is. So now I can select it anywhere. So let's test that out. I'll use this test one here again. I'll run. Let me close Automator. I'm just here in the Finder. Go to Finder, Services, close all notifications. Now security is going to stop it from working because basically it's asking the Finder to control system events. So that's fine. I'm going to hit OK and then I'm going to go to System Preferences and then go to Security. Look under Accessibility and authenticate here by hitting the padlock and allow the Finder accessibility options here. So now when I do it in the Finder, it should work. And there you go, you see it happens. So the downside of this is you have to do that for every app. But you typically use the same app. So Let's, for instance, go into Pages here and say I'm writing in Pages, and this is where I get this problem here. So I have a test document open in Pages. Let's go back to Automator and throw up those test notifications. Great. So now I try to do it in Pages, Services, Close All Notifications, and I'm going to get the same thing. So I'm going to say OK, and then I'm going to have to go back to System Preferences. I'm going to go to Security and Privacy, and then add under Privacy Accessibility Pages. So I should see it here in the list, and it's now asked for permission. I check it and it's OK. I could preemptively accept some other things as well, so I can check off some other things in here. So now when I go back to Pages and I go to Services and Close All Notifications, it works. So now that's all that's left is to set a keyboard shortcut. So I'll go to System Preferences. This time I'll go to Keyboard and I'll add a shortcut. I'll do an app shortcut here. I'll add one by hitting the plus button. Say in all applications, use the menu title, which is exactly what I named it. So that's exactly what's in Services here. Close All Notifications. They have to match perfectly. And I'll do a keyboard shortcut of, let's say, F9. Now it should work just by hitting F9. So I'll go into Automator here. I'll do my test. Hide Automator. I'm typing here in Pages. Those are bugging me. I hit F9 and they go away. So it's far from perfect because you have to give all those permissions. But as soon as you assign permissions to the main apps that you use, then it becomes pretty quick keyboard shortcut to get rid of all notifications. Now note that you can modify this to actually just get rid of the first notification. If after Windows I just say just do the first item, item number 0 in Windows, then it's going to get rid of the first one. So now I can test, bring those three up. I'll switch to Pages, and now when I hit F9 it'll just get rid of the very first one. So I hit F9 again and again and again. So if I prefer to get rid of them one at a time, I can do it by making that small alteration to the code, just adding that 0 there. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.